product management team. We have the capacity of 6 or 7 developers teams for your team and for your team. So you should go back to saying that, okay, you give me the product backlog, right? You got the product backlog now. See, I'm jumping here and there because there will be a small session for product backlog, then blah, blah. So this is the product. Yeah, it's almost equivalent. Like no one is, it's all epic is already in the
so
story level.
So we should prioritize or the product management should prioritize? No, product. They'll just say that
you make sure
all
that
this
epic yeah.
should be delivered, that's it, right? We'll have to prioritize it.
No.
It's a good question. Story product management. I think some of the requirement will fail. Epic is what?
Yeah, I mean, story and corresponding acceptance criteria has to be defined.
Exactly, number one. Right? And once this is defined, then you make sure that it is on the prioritized list, right? Without getting the prioritized list, you cannot trade off. Suppose the product owner is given this priority, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But what you can do is that being as that I can trade off between 1, I can make it 4, because 4 is a little bit of easier for me, and both are dependent, right? So make 2 here, right? Now what you can do the trade off is saying that, okay, in 2 and 5, I think the 8 is purely related to this one, I can complete here, and then 6 and 7, little bit of. Don't give the. At least you should get to the. sorry, story for this sprint 1 and 2. At least 2 couple of sprints ahead, you should get all those details, and all should be in the epic level. That's fine. But you should get. You see the product roadmap, the release plan. You understood whatever I'm saying. This kind of trade-off is going to happen during the release planning, and there is a separate release planning meeting. Right, before you start up the release.
Has it happened for your code?
No. Full plus pulling point estimations and then all those things. Right, so make sure that release planning project is another round. I'm not saying that team is really the contribution, all are wrong. The Scrum Master and the product management team, they are the responsible, accountable for this kind of activities, release plan. Right, when it comes to the product roadmap, it is the product management. There is no Scrum Masters or developed teams. Here in the release plan, this Scrum Master development is front plus the product management.
It is the owned by the industry.
It is not by the product owner. But when it comes to the product roadmap, it is owned by the product owner. It is the team. And it is in between. So in between who? Product owner plus Scrum Master. So Scrum Master plus lead. Yeah. So they are the
your capacity
is 7. Even if 7 or 9 hours you work, you give it 50%, 4 and 5 hours. And then 32 hours. Plus you use the calculation of 10 to 15% buffer. Scope is fixed. Right, we have to complete, and the schedule is fixed, as Madhav was saying. Then we need to depends on these capacities. We need to add resources, right? If we scope is not fixed, but resources
to
fixed.
Make sure that
our daily standard should be 15 minutes, but we never did it. Why?
Daily standard was.
This is another thing we need to take care. Why we never pushed back saying that no 15 minutes. Because that time we are seeing that okay, some effective communication is there. Let us people start at the daily standup. Let them continue for a couple of weeks or a couple of spring. And then we should have given some ideas. No, make sure that 15 minutes. So being a now Scrum Master, you make sure that you try to make it a shortcut to 15 minutes. Right? How you will make it? You have a printout of definition of done in front of your list, right? Make sure that your team understand very well following that step by step, right? And make sure during the sprint planning you don't make with the story point estimations. I'm not speaking on this general like story point estimation, right? As a Scrum Master, I will tell about the let me write another make process. Process is a very important part of the Scrum Master. So story point estimations, then tasking, right? And then task hour. And then make sure that you are in the tool, version 1 tools. So this is all the who facilitated this?
Scrum Masters,
right? You make sure that the moment you are completing the sprint planning and don't drag it to
second
time,
what is
the
hour, point?
Not on the hour. Right? You don't see how much hour we are completing. There are two kind of one down chart this tool will give you.
It's
one
for
is,
the entire sprint, right?
Yeah, entire sprint. One sprint. Entire sprint, right? So okay, this is the one down chart, right? This is the sprint 1. Day 1, 2, 3, till 10. 5, 10 working days, right? We have identified during sprint planning that we are going to give them 2, 12 story points, right? This is the day 1 sprint planning meeting. It will be flat, right? And day 2 also flat. Day 3 we have completed 3 story, which is equal to 32 story points. completed, right? So minus 32, which is equal to 180, right? So the graph will come like this. This is 1, this is 1. So like this. So this is called as burn down chart. What does it mean, Nimesh? You are burning down. What it signifies, Vijay?
It is getting to the completion. It is getting to the completion.
How many hours already completed?
Hour? No, this is not hour.
Yeah.
This is not hour, Nimesh. This is Krishna. This is story point. That's what I'm saying. This is story point burn down chart. Story point burn down chart.
Story point wise are we...
That's what I'm saying. A good scrum master should look on that. There are two types of story point.
Another
burn off chart, right? This story point burn off chart. So what does it mean? So from day one, we have completed day one, zero. Day two, zero. Day three, we have completed 32. There are two sides of burn down and burn off chart. 32. And then we have completed, say, example, again, we have completed, what is it, 40. So 32, 55 we have completed, for example, right? So what the difference between these two?
So it shows the remaining story.
Perfect, yeah, excellent. This shows that what is the remaining. Whether you have a glass, you say whether it's half full or half empty or
how is it will be measured?
Now, since suppose you three are now becoming the scrum master in future, I will tell you, I am coming first. Krishna, what is your velocity of your scrum? And what is your? It means how much, every sprint, how much you are consuming the story point. From the day sprint one, we have consumed, say, for example, 22 story points in the sprint one. Sprint two, it will be a little bit of higher. And it will go up till the time we establish the baselines, like that will be your constantly moving. And that time, it become your velocity. So that's what in the real time, Agile says that wait for 2-3 sprint, let the team complete couple of stories till they stabilize, then you decide your velocity. Now, what will happen in 2.2? You remember sprint 1-0, we have not done anything, right? Sprint 2 and 3, we little bit of improve. Till the time people understand the process, branch, merging, all this, technical practices. Till the time they achieve a certain baseline of the standard, that time you calculate your velocity. So the agile transition happens like this. The validation team or the advanced user testing is not done by the development team. Say for example, India development team, we have a visual wall, or we have the flow for the development team. The moment we are saying it's done, we are ensuring that as per the definition of done, we are checking all those things, then we are marking it done. If it is marking done, it is reflecting here. It is not only reflecting here. This data is going to another window, like we have a storyboard, dashboard,
so right?
And that we are using 1 to 2, and then 2 to 3, then 3 to 4. So what's wrong here? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. That's fine. You are doing something little bit. The rule says that there is something called as Little's rule. Little's rule says that don't add new stories unless and until this work in progress tasks are completed. If your pile of the work in progress task is more than adding new one, it makes no sense. Because you are failing this agile principle. Make it complete, work in progress. So minimize the WIP limit, that is called as term is called as WIP limit, work in progress limit. Minimize that one.